In today's video, I show you step by step how to make a custom phone case with Fusion 360 and how to 3D print it. Fusion 360 is a 3D modeling software from Autodesk. If you have never done 3D modeling before, don't be intimidated. Fusion 360 has made 3D modeling much easier than ever. In the solid mode of Fusion 360, you create a 3D body by drawing a profile on a plane, then applying commands like extrude or revolve. Let's start by drawing a rectangle on the horizontal plane. Click on Create Sketch and select the horizontal plane. Then click on Create Rectangle, 2-point rectangle. Draw the rectangle by clicking on the origin and dragging the mouse. The blue line indicates that the rectangle is not yet fully constrained. We still need to provide dimensions for the width and height. Before doing this, let's define a thickness parameter and set its value to 1 mm. Setting the thickness as a parameter is useful because we can refer to it or adjust it in one place. We can now measure the width and length of our phone. Click on Sketch Dimension or press D. Then select the width of the rectangle and enter its dimension. The width of the cover is the width of the phone plus 2 times the covered thickness. Do the same for the height. You can zoom in and out and display the sketch with the middle wheel of your mouse. Click on Finish Sketch. We can now turn this rectangle into a 3D body using Extrude. To round the corners, click Fillet. Select the 4 corners and type in the radius you measured on your phone. To be able to slide the phone inside the case, it must be made hollow. Click on Create Sketch and select the top of the case. Click Offset. Select the outline of the case and set -2 thickness for the offset. Extrude can be used again, but this time to make a hole. Instead of entering a dimension, we request the hole to extend to the bottom of the cover, minus the cover thickness. To complete this step, we use the shell tool and enter the desired thickness. To visualize a cross-section of what we just did, we can use the section analysis tool in the Inspect menu. Using the Inspect tool, we can also measure the dimensions, like on a real object, and check that the phone will fit inside the cover. The next step is to make holes for the buttons and the connectors. Again, click on Create Sketch. Select the face where you want to make the hole. Draw a rectangle and enter its dimensions. To cut the hole, use again Extrude. We proceed the same way for the other holes. This completes the design of the 3D model. To 3D print this part, we first need to export it as a STL file. To do this, simply right-click on the top component and select Save as Mesh. You can now open the STL file in a slicing software like Ultimaker Cura. Slicers convert the STL file into G-code, a sequence of commands that 3D printers follow to print the 3D object. The final step is to print the G-code file on your 3D printer. If you are like me, the first prototype is never perfect and requires some updates to the 3D model. In my case, some holes need to be adjusted, but above all, the hole for the camera is on the wrong side. Back to the digital drawing board. At the bottom of the screen is the timeline. Navigate back to the step you want to update. Double-click on this step. In my case, I want to move the hole for the camera on the other side. Here is version 2. I also printed the case in TPU. To print TPU, we need to update the print profile. Start with a standard quality profile in Cura. Change the printing temperature to 220 degrees C. The bed temperature to 0 degrees C. Make sure the print speed is less than 50 mm per second. Disable retractions, enable comping mode, and disable print cooling. Unfortunately, the cover is too thin. As the cover thickness is a design parameter in Fusion 360, I can easily increase it to 2 mm and try again. Thanks for watching!